whether we were doing the question answers of lesson number 6, a grain as big as a hen's egg. And we have already done exercise B, if you remember. First part was there, second part was there, we finished, and the third part. Then exercise C we started, this one. Answer these questions. Question number 1 we did. What did the children find in the ravine? How did the object reach the king? How did the wise men discover what the object was? Why did the king want to meet a very old peasant? If you remember better, this we have already done. Like, answer these questions. Question number 1 we did. The children found a large grain in the ravine. Then question number 2 was there. This also we have done. Question number 3 also we have done. And answer number 4. Then from here we have to start. Then let's see question number 5. Let's try to understand. Why did the old man describe the object as a fine grain? Why did the old man describe the object as a fine grain? You remember? Better because that was large in size and very, very tasty. Because the third one, the oldest one, when he tasted it, no, he told about the things, if you remember. So let's start writing answer 5. This one I have already written, so I'm going to read, you're going to write. The old man described the object. Start writing. The old man described the object as a fine grain because it was large and tasty. Because it was large and tasty. Very good. Now question number 6. This is little lengthy because they have asked two things in this. Let's see. Although interesting and although the answer is little lengthy but interesting. List the questions that the king asked the last peasant, the third one, the oldest one. You have to list down all the questions. How did the peasant answer the king's final two questions? But if you remember, let's move to this page, you will find out. See here, he asked so many questions. We already underlined few things. You know, I have two more questions like this one. The first is, why did the earth bear such a grain then and has ceased it to do so now? Then why you look more healthier than your son? You know, all these questions. These were the two final questions. One thing they have asked about that, what the last answers, what answers he gave for the last two questions which the king asked. Otherwise, he asked here also, when and where such corn grown, then have you ever bought any like it or sown any in your field? So these all questions we are supposed to write. Okay, so let's start writing. Now answer number 6, write down in your notebooks. I'm going to read question better, you have to write by your own. So let's start. The king asked the last peasant these questions, and the last peasant was the oldest one. When and where, better put the dot, don't put 1, 2, 3, put the dot. When and where was such corn grown? Write down, put the question mark, leave the lines the way I've left. First of all, the king asks the last peasant these questions. Leave the line, put a dot. When and where was such corn grown? Question mark. Very good. Second dot, had he bought or sown such grains? Had he bought or sown such grains? The third one. Why did the earth bear such grain then? THEN. And does not anymore? Question mark. Why did the earth bear such grain then? And does not anymore? Question mark. Then the fourth dot, number one dot, second, third and fourth. Why did his grandson walk with two crutches? His son with one, while he did not need any? Question mark. So all the four questions were very, 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 very relevant. And really from these all questions we came to know about the times. That time when the oldest one was and how the things were so pure, and things and the heart both were so pure. So beta, the next part of the question was like, how did the peasant answer the king's final two questions? So you have to start writing. The peasant answered the king's final two questions. Final two questions by saying that humans had ceased. But a ceased means stopped. I already told while reading that humans had ceased, C-E-A-S-E-D, ceased to live by their own labor, L-A-B-O-U-R. This is little not clear. I'm going to write here L-A-B-O-U-R, labor, this word. By saying that humans had ceased to live by their own labor, full stop. Better see the spelling of labor, I've written here clearly. Instead, full stop, I capital, instead, they depended on others' labor. They started looking at others' thing. In, full stop, in the olden times, humans lived on what they produced and did not want what others had. So beautiful lines. See, we all have to learn from these lines. You tell this story even to your grandparents, to your parents, to your brother, sister. This is so lovely story, bete. In the olden times, humans lived on what they produced and did not want what others had. This is the basic line from where you can learn the things. Even your grandparents, when you're going to tell them, they are going to teach you more good things about this story. Now, exercise D, think and answer. This also you can use the colorful pen, but this is going to make your notebook more colorful. Question number one. So let's see what is the question over there for exercise D. Why do you think the children sold the object for a penny? For a very short, small amount. For a penny, whereas the traveler sold it to the king as a curiosity. Yeah, see, the question itself is telling you the meaning. Why do you think the children sold the object for a penny? Because they better didn't recognize. They didn't realize the value of that unusual object which they got. But whereas the traveler, he understood. He instantly recognized it well, its value. And that is the only reason he took it to the king and who saw its worth. So this we are going to write. So let's start writing the answer. This one I'm going to write and you people are going to write along with me. Come on, with full energy. So write down the children. The children did not realize. The children did not realize, L-I-S-E, did not realize. The children did not realize the value of an unusual, A-L, just see that I've also written correctly or not. Unusual. Very good. The children did not realize the value of an unusual grain of corn. Don't worry, we are going to read again. Of corn. So they sold it to the traveler for a penny. Whereas however E-V-R, however, comma, instantly, very quickly, instantly recognized its value and took it to the king who saw its worth. Yeah, the value. So let's read once again. So nicely, the children did not realize the value of an unusual, see the spelling, unusual grain of corn. So they sold it to the traveler for a penny. Whereas the traveler, however, instantly, very quickly, recognized its value and took it to the king who saw its worth. Full stop. Now the second, think and answer. So question number two, you're going to write from the book. So answer. So let's read the question. What is there? Why do you think the old man considered selling and buying grain a sin? An evil thing. Why do you think the old man considered? But if you remember, during his time, you know, the people, they only considered the labor as their own. They don't, and the land, God's land. So buying and selling could then automatically would be a sin, because the people, they considered only on their own things. They don't want what others have. So this is such a good question. So let's start writing the answer. Answer number two, start writing, bete. In the old man's time, people only owned their labor, not land. They had no concept of money. Produce of God's land. And another person's labor. Person's labor, which would be a sin, See, so nice lines. Let's read once again. In the old man's time, people only owned their labor, comma, not land. They had no concept of money, full stop. So if they bought grain, they would be buying the produce of God's land and another person's labor, which would be a sin. Very good. So next one, question number 3, the last one for thinking the answer. Let's complete this chapter. The first old man used 2 crutches. Oh yeah. And his father used 1 crutch, while his grandfather, the oldest one, used none. This was so surprising, no? But we came to know when we read the story. What is the significance of this? Or what does this indicate? So let's see. Let's write the answer. Start writing, but this indicates. This indicates that as the generations this indicates that as the generations progressed as the generation progressed comma health issues health issues became more common. Health issues became more common and quality of life and quality of life decreased. The only thing is, Pete, we have to keep our heart pure. You're not supposed to think anything evil of anyone. So that was the only thing. See, this indicates that as the generations progressed, health issues became more common. Yeah, the people, they were, you know, the impure things came in the mind and, yeah, in the work. So that only causes the health problems. Became more common and the quality of life decreased. So this is the end, whether this chapter now is complete. Yeah, I think we are left with the grammar study here. Although we have finished with all the question answers, word study we already have done in the previous video, the grammar study. And in the next video, we are going to do that. Okay, so take care and always respect your parents and your grandparents. Thank you. God bless you.